Now, welcome back. And we live in a First Nations continent full of culture, history and fantastic native ingredients that vary across our environment and country. Currie Country is a brilliant organisation owned by one of the largest traditional owner families. They grow and provide award-winning native ingredients to local chefs in Tweed. Arabella Douglas is the fabulous and inspiring person behind Currie Country and joins us now live in our studio with two very talented chefs, Alex and Luke. Happy NAIDOC week to everybody here. It's a pleasure to speak to you.
Happy NAIDOC week.
Thanks for here. Now, Arabella, tell us about Currie Country and the incredible work that you do with native ingredients.
Jingawala, and that's my hello and greeting from Bundjalung Nation. We're a Bundjalung First Nation family. So we're up in the Tweed and Byron coast. And of course, we grow gorgeous native ingredients, which you can see on the table. And we collaborate with incredible chefs in our region.
Fantastic. Now, you're telling me it's so important to regionalise native food. Why so?
I think because there's a lack of understanding that, in fact, the soil and the water that actually impacts the food or the environment that impacts it creates an extension of the flavour and taste. And you need to collaborate with incredible alchemist chefs to be able to experience that. So that's what we do.
Tell us about the kangaroos on Lambie Island in Dublin. I know about this. I was like, why is the wallabies in Dublin? But they're there.
Yeah, so I got the chance to go down to the Taste of West Cork down in Ireland to showcase native ingredients with my twin brother. And, yeah, we went down there, grabbed a kangaroo from Lambie Island and cooked it up for all the Irish people. I loved it.
How's your brother? Is he a good cook?
Yeah, he's good.
He's all right. He's not here, though, is he? No. Currie Country, you also run some incredible fall and new moon events. What can you share about the experience of those events with us?
Well, we actually engage gorgeous chefs in our region, again, in the Tweed and Byron Coast, to come on and do a co-created event. So it's a very luxe event. You come on, enjoy some cultural information. You come and swim in waters, sacred waters, for example. And we have chefs that actually create an incredible meal based on the season. Six seasons in our calendar. Yeah. There are sometimes six and eight season in other nations' calendars. So we actually get a chef to create and co-create an experience with us on water.
Fantastic. Now, I like talking about food, but I prefer eating the food. And you've brought in two beautiful dishes here as well. Can you tell us a little bit about what you've made there?
So what we've got here is a spaghetti that's actually made with a little bit of bunya nut. So bunya nut is basically a huge pine cone. If it falls on your head, you're a goner.
Right.
And then inside that is a shell. Inside that shell is another shell, and then there's a nut. We grind that into a flour and make a bit of pasta with it. And then there's a butter sauce that's made with some lemon myrtle. So the idea with this is essentially it's flavours everyone is familiar with. You know, you could serve this to an Italian nonna and she would go, it tastes like something from Italy, but it's made with Indigenous ingredients. And the idea with that is we're doing food that people are comfortable with, people are kind of really, really happy with those flavour profiles, but we're introducing Indigenous ingredients to them and showing them that these aren't things to be scared of. These are things that you can use in your everyday cooking and everyday life.
And that's what we want, isn't it? Yeah. And how about your dish here?
So we just got a yellowfin tuna, sashimi style, just chopped up raw. And then I've got some Davidson plum powder, so a native plum. They've freeze-dried it, so I poured that over the top. Some little caviar or finger lime, so the native caviar of Australia. And just some fried saltbush to finish it off.
I'm going to try this now in 2 seconds. I'm just going to ask you one more question now. How would you like to see the native food space transform?
I think what people need to appreciate is that co-collaboration with First Nations people is very distinctive in different regions. Yeah. And I would encourage the best chefs to get about it and start to engage with First Nations people, both foraging for sophisticated dishes, but also incorporating that into their everyday existence. Foraging for First Nations people is a First Nations right, so First Nations people should do that activity. Or you can, of course, grow on a farm like we do.
Which is fantastic. And it being NAIDOC week as well, what conversations are you hoping that we have when it comes to this?
I think that people need to embrace NAIDOC week as a true element of who we are as a nation, being about human rights and about being equal and the equality of both First Nations people and the equality of everyone. I think it's something to be embraced, and I think a way to have that conversation over food, which starts that conversation, is a very, very elegant way to begin.
Fantastic. We have Guinness and you have this. Am I going to get stuck into it? Because it's NAIDOC week and I'm doing my part too. And I'll taste this one as well. I've never had any of this before.
How's that?
Oh, jeez, that's not bad at all, huh?
That's really, really good.
How are you with twirling the pasta on a fork?
I'm going to do what?
Twirl it. Yeah,
in and in. There's a bit of Italian in there somewhere, mate.
Oh, my Lord.
That's good.
I almost want to eat it up. This is fantastic. For more information on Currie Country, visit the website curriecountry.com or keep up to date on Instagram by following at Currie our Currie Country. Arabella, Alex and Luke, thank you so much for joining us. Thanks for feeding me. Happy NAIDOC week. You're going to choke now. I've got a bit of pasta in my trunk. You know, if this was the last meal I've ever had, though, it's fantastic.